Welcome to Peacock in the Park 1994. For those of you that are visiting up on the top of the amphitheater, don't quite know what's going on, this is the kickoff to Gay Pride, Gay and Lesbian Pride 1994, Portland style. We'd like to welcome you to join us, if you please. Our show is good for the entire family. We don't swear very much.
Hi, Ryan. How are you?
It's been a long year. I'd like to talk with you for a couple of minutes about something that we need to not dwell on, but be aware of. I'm going to do the show just a little bit backwards than sometimes. Of course, I do that way sometimes anyway. I want to do the thank yous early on so that all of you know who helped pull this together. And I want to tell you, after this last year, it took an awful lot of people to fill in one person's place. I'm not joking about that one little bit. I want to share a story with you that started about 2 months ago, and it was quite scary. Many of you have experienced some of the feelings that I'm going to describe to you, and this is not to start the show on a downside. Not at all. But we need to be aware, we need to take care of each other, we need to be appreciating what is happening to our community worldwide. 2 months ago, I sat down in our living room, starting the outline for this show. I had already put it off 2 months well beyond where I should have. Sat down with a clipboard and started listing the jobs, the key jobs that have to happen in order for this show to be a success every year. This is just my part of doing the job for the last 8 years. Out of about 9 key positions, 7, and I will list them for you, 7 of the 9 people are not here today. 7 people died since this day last year that were key to putting on this program. And I want you to know and understand, because when I go through this list, you will appreciate the resources that we are beginning to lose. David Evans, a friend of the community, the City Nightclub especially, who took videos of this show and everything else that Peacock ever did in public, some things in private, since day one, is no longer with us. That's why the video from last year is not available. With the exception of a short Silverado version of the show, which included some cruising and that kind of stuff. And it's a nice video and it's a fond memory for me, but it's not a saleable sort of thing. Cedric Williams, who is our roommate, was also Woody's dresser and confidant with regards to what to wear and what to do and what numbers and all that kind of stuff, which I am not at all into. Keeston Lowry, who worked for the city, always made it easy, always made the flow for us through the Parks Bureau. Whenever there was a hiccup or a problem, he'd pick up the phone and start smoothing out for us. And he did that for a lot of organizations. Dan Egan, Mother Dan to most of us, at the Embers Avenue, who always saw to it that we had our cordless microphones, which were so fun to play with. You know, you could go anywhere. And Bruce Watson, God bless his soul, who created more floats in this city than I think any other designer for the Rose Festival, and created this set and every set we've had from day one. By the time I got through that list, I was devastated. I really felt like Agatha Christie's story, and then there was one. Threw the clipboard and couldn't get back to it for a month. I approached the Rose Court and asked them to help me. I've heard people say before, the Rose Court never does anything. I will tell you, don't ever tell me that again, whoever and wherever you are. Because the hard work and virtually hundreds of hours of reorganizing, rethinking, and trying to ensure that this show, and from now on, this show, will continue in Peacock fashion and class. We have about 40 or 50 Rose Court members that have given very, very selflessly of their time, energy, and resources to put it on today. To those people, I am personally grateful. Oh yeah, in the list of people, Misty Waters, who is Woody's sister. And last but not least, the star of the show, who still is. She went out of her way to scare the hell out of me today with these clouds and a little mist this morning. I thought, no girl, you're up there now. You better be taking care of this because we're not doing last year again. The scholarship fund last year, for most of the years in the last, oh, I'd say about 5 or 6 years, has given away around $3,000 each year. Last year, Woody and I about lost it when, because of the rain, so many people left, and we only took in about $1,700. Because of the dedication of so many people in this community, including our Emperor and Empress Maria and Babalu, who have dedicated many of their fundraisers this year and their efforts to raise funds, I am very pleased to announce that we will be giving, oh yes, and the generosity of two of the board members of Equity Foundation that administers the scholarship fund, we will be giving away $3,900 in scholarships today, which is a new high for us in more ways than one. There's been some debate in the community as to whether I should produce the show or not, as to whether Maria should host the show or not. Let the debate end here and now. It was a stipulation in Woody's will that I produce the show until death do us part, or rejoin as the case may be, and that Maria and Kimberly, her lover, will host and direct the direction of this show from here on out. I will remain a part of it. We're very proud of those people. We clearly understood that it takes more than one person to produce a show of this magnitude. Maria has done an incredible job, and Kim has done an incredible job of support of Maria.
Oh, Dad, you're gonna make me.
To continue the people that have been an integral part in the last year, I want to publicly thank the friends of the PWA Foundation. I think that that is an organization in this city which I am proud to be seated on the board of, and so is Peacock. That I think that is an organization in this city that is seriously undersold and not understood. They made Woody's life far more comfortable in the last few months, and they made mine incredibly more possible in the first few months afterwards. And if you have money to throw in somebody's direction, believe me, they're very worthwhile recipients. If you don't know the PWA Foundation, I suggest you do a little bit of research and find out. They provide the real things that people need, like money, porta potties for at home when a person is bedridden, wheelchairs, crutches, and the like. And those of us in this audience that are with AIDS, and in fact do have our good days and our bads, know just how much that means. It means the difference between lying in bed and wishing you were dead, or being able to get up and come to a function like this and feel good about it at the end of the day. You bet. You bet. It means everything. I want to thank CAP for being here again this year, and I mentioned earlier, if you haven't seen these fun little things they made for Peacock in the Park, take a look at one of them. They're a peacock purse. And you know one of his favorite sayings, you're cute, what's your name and address? Well, they put a little black book in each one of these. And they put a picture of lipstick. So that's a fair representation, I think. What more is to be said? They're passing out information for us to strive to protect ourselves, take care of ourselves, and be here for the cure. The Rose Court is staffing the sale, or not sale, but the distribution of hot dogs, Peacock memorabilia, pictures and fans, and that sort of thing. and soft drinks over here. We ask for donations. Those donations all go to the scholarship fund. The things that are being distributed have all been donated or paid for in years gone by. Also, the Portland Mint just announced about 2 or 3 weeks ago a new set of medallions, keychains, that sort of thing, that you can have the name of a loved one that has passed on, or a loved one that's still with you for that matter, on the back side of these coins. And they're really nice and they're not that expensive. So if you're interested, take a look. We're not selling anything today. You can place an order, but we're not selling anything here. Thank you very much. I'm so happy that you're all here. I'm very proud of Maria and this whole crew, because we were here at 8 o'clock this morning after being out until o'clock last night. Going around reminding everybody that this is the Sunday. Not last week, not next week, and not the 10th or something like that. Thank you, and thank you. Without any further delay, without any further nonsense from me, because you all know I'm not a performer. In a tribute to those who put so much time and effort into putting on Peacock in the Park, in the past, in the present, and in the future, and to the person whom we are here to celebrate, Lady Elaine Peacock. Like Darcel in an auction. I'm trying to get through these cards and they're sticking together. And to Misty Waters, her sister. The children of Audrea Edwards, whom the scholarship is named after. I want to present to you Nikki, Sissy, Rose Empress, Maria.